So let's take a look at how to use Siri shortcuts on iOS to create animated GIFs from live photos, right? Live photos are really cool and useful. And you think, oh, that would make the perfect little animated GIF that I can then post to Facebook or something. But there is no export as GIF functionality. However, you can do that in shortcuts. So launching the shortcuts app, and if you don't have it, of course, download it from the iOS App Store. You can, it seems, easily create a new shortcut and have it go and make an animated GIF. So let's search here in the functions for GIF. And there is one called Make GIF. So let's drag that one over. And we see we've got some settings here. So great. So now we've got that. Now how do we want the photo to get into this shortcut? You would think that the way to do that is to go to Settings and have it show in the Share sheet. So you can go into Photos, say Share this photo, and then choose this shortcut. However, it doesn't work, unfortunately. Maybe it will one day in the future, but right now if you try to share a live photo this way, it sees it as a single photo and it gives you an error saying you can't create an animated GIF from a single photo. But if you were to actually choose the live photo, then it will actually see it correctly. Now, it turns out there is a shortcut for that. Get latest live photos. And if you say give me the latest one, then it takes the last live photo you took and it puts it into this function. But that doesn't help if we don't want to use the latest one. What if we want to use, you know, one from something earlier? So one way we can do it is we could say choose, you know, several photos, like six live photos, and then say choose from a list. But it's better to be able to choose anything. So we're going to go instead, we'll do photos, and there's select photos, and you'll be able to go and make a selection. This is a little dangerous because you can easily select a regular photo, not a live photo. But you know, providing you select a live photo, it's going to work. Now you'd think this works, right? Take the live photo, make it a GIF. Well, it still doesn't work because it still doesn't use the live photo as a piece of video. It uses it as a single photo. So this is where you think, well, I'm at a dead end. I can't make this work. However, there is a way. There's something called Encode Media, and we can put that in between here. And it basically says, okay, I'm going to take this photo that's coming in and I'm going to encode it and I'm going to basically make no changes at all. So I'm just going to pat it same size, not audio only, it's going to be video, normal speed and all that. No changes to the metadata or anything like that. You can change stuff like that. But it will then see this live photo as a piece of video rather than a photo. And now it makes a GIF. And now the great thing is that we can use Quick Look. I love the Quick Look action as a way to end a shortcut because it shows you the result and it gives you a little share button. So instead of having to go and say, well, this is going to share by messages or share to Facebook, instead it's going to give you all the options you want, including doing nothing with it. So let's go and try this shortcut here. Press the play button. Allowed me to select a photo. Now you can go to the live photos. There I've got 409 live photos. I can do that. I have a smaller little subset here that I've created called sample live photos. So it gives me three of them there. And I will select one. And it's going to bring that one in. And then it's going to run the rest of the script there. Encode the media. And after it encodes it, it'll make the GIF and then it shows it to me. And there you go. I got a little animated GIF there. And now I have that share button, like I said, so I can do all sorts of different things with it or nothing with it, just it done. Now there are a lot of cool options. Like for instance, I could go in and say a number of seconds per photo. I can change that. I can make it a much smoother one, so 0.05 rather than 0.2 there. And I can play around with whether or not to auto size or, you know, change it to a specific size if I want. So I could say, you know, I would make it much more horizontal video rather than something at square if I wanted to. And I can hit done. Or let's test this out now with this new one. It should be a much smoother animated GIF. And now you can see the result here. It's much smoother. There are many more frames in there. So this is really handy. It's a really nice thing to have. One of the cool things is I'm not saying anywhere in here it has to be a live photo. So I can actually choose a video and the video will actually work as well. So this is kind of a script that allows me to choose a video or a live photo and convert it to an animated GIF. In the settings here I'll probably want to give this a name. And then maybe choose where to show it so I can show it in the widget, or I don't want to have this in the share sheet. It's not going to work there. I can add it to the home screen if I want. And I can add to Siri so I can actually give this an audio Siri command. I can also change the icon to make it something more appropriate to fit that. And now that's done, and now I can see it in there and I can just tap it and use it anytime I want to create a cool animated GIF and then share it with any service that I want to share it with.